Hi, it's Paul. Today I'm going to do the traffic lights and I'm going to do it in structured text. I'm pretty much starting right from the beginning. Let's take a look at what I have here. Here's my trainer and I'm only using the top lights. I've got this set up for doing additional things. I've got a walk and don't walk, and I've got a counter. But I'm not going to use any of that. All I'm going to do is a very simple traffic light. If you look at my Studio 5000 here, I've got a routine called Traffic ST. And when I check my main program, my properties, configuration, that routine is my main routine. If you set up your new routine and either you don't have a jump to subroutine or you don't make it your main routine, then it's not going to run. So make sure you take care of that. Okay, here I've got all my lights. I've got north green, yellow, red, and east green, yellow, and red. And right now I have them all set to zero. I'm just going to space this out a bit so that everything is lined up. Okay, now they're all lined up. Those are the six lights I'm going to deal with. And since I always want two of them on and the rest off, I'm not going to use any else statements because I want to turn two lights on and then I want to turn two different lights on as they cycle from green, yellow, and red. Before I get to that, I need a timer. So let me space this down a bit. And I'm only going to use one timer in this. So I'll start with TONR. And I'm going to call that, I'll just call it T1. And now when I do that, I've got some errors already. I have the little red squiggly under my T1. Maybe I'll zoom in a little bit. I'll right click on that and it says, do you want to make a new tag? Sure. And it knows I want an FBD timer, so I'll create that. There's my T1 timer. Next thing I want to do is I want to set up my timer to run. So I want three things I need to put in. I need my preset, I need to lock it on, and then I need to have it reset as soon as it finishes so that it starts over again. First thing I need is my T1.pre, and I'll set that to, I'm going to set that to 10 seconds. Make sure that it got it. So structured text doesn't really care about capitals. You can use small letters, capitals. Sometimes it's easier to stay organized if you use capitals, but it's kind of a personal choice. I'm just going to fix that to capital. Next, I want to have it locked on all the time. So T1.timerEnable. I'll set that equal to 1. And notice I forgot my semicolon there. That's going to lock that timer on all the time. I don't want the timer ever stopping. And lastly, I need to reset it. Timer 1 reset is assigned to timer 1.done. When the timer 1 finishes, it's going to make itself reset. And I think on the top line, I'm going to put, this is my timer. So I'll just put a comment there on the top line. Sometimes I like to separate my code with just a bunch of slashes just to show that it's a different section. Okay, Now, I've got my timer. Now I need to set up my lights. I'm going to start this with an if. So I'm going to say if T1.acc. I'm going to see if it's greater than 0 or T1.acc is less than, I'll put this 5 seconds. So if timer one, if the accumulated time is greater than 0 and less than 5 seconds, then I'm going to set north green to on. I'm not going to do that yet. I'm going to put my end if at the end. And I'll just tab that out a little bit so it looks better. Okay, there's my if statement. Now, if timer 1 ACC is less than 5 seconds or greater than 0, all the lights are off. I don't want all the lights off, but before I change that, I'm gonna just copy and paste that code below. And I'm gonna do that 4 times. Okay, I've got 4 conditions. So my first one, I'm gonna set that north green to on, and I'm gonna set the east red on. In my second condition, if I'm greater than 5,000 and less than, I'll say 5,500, I've got a real short yellow. In that case, north yellow's gonna come on. North or east red is still going to stay on. If I'm greater than 5,500 and less than, what's my timer? 10,000. And less than 9,500, then my north red will be on and my east green will be on. And lastly, if I'm greater than 9,500 and less than 10,000, then my north red will still be on and my east yellow will go on. Those are my 4 only conditions. I've got north green, east red, and then north goes to yellow, east stays at red, and then east goes to green, north goes to red, and lastly, east goes yellow and north goes red. And then after that, the timer's going to reset and I'll start all over again. Let's go online and see if it works. I guess first I'll check my routine, and I have 2 errors. Line 5 and line 8. So let's see what's going on. I didn't have my semicolon there. Line 8. Probably that's the same error. Let's check it again. So now I'm complete with no errors. And it looks like I have all my semicolons in. Let's go online and see if that works. It's downloaded. Change it back to run mode. Connect my factory I/O. And let's see what's going on. Doesn't seem to be working. Let's look at my tags and see if we can see what's going on. All right, I'm back. I did all my code and it all looked right, but my scene was not working. And I could not see what was wrong with it. Instead of OR, I should have been using AND in all these statements. So So what was happening is it would use, I think it was locked onto this last condition instead of my ORs. Okay, that should be all fixed up. Let's go back online and see if it's working. All right, that's downloaded. Let's go back to run mode, connect factory IO. And as we can see on factory IO, it seems to be cycling through. Each set of lights goes from green, yellow, red, green, yellow, red. Okay, so that's the basics of setting up my traffic light. Over here, I tell it I want to use a timer. I put in my timer preset. I use 10 seconds, you can use whatever you want. My timer enable is locked on, so that timer never stops. And my reset is my done bit. So as soon as that timer gets up to 10 seconds, it resets and it starts over. So this timer always runs, and if I show my tags, down here I can see my timer timing, and I can see the different values changing on my output tags. So it's a very simple traffic light setup. If I wanted to, I could make it a little more complex with adding in adding in a counter. I could add in a sensor for a walk signal. I can do a lot of different things with it. But the first thing I have to do is I have to get my traffic light so it works. And I've got that now. So now that I have that, I can go and do different things with it. Okay, thanks for watching, and click the like button on the video. Talk to you later.